Danny Chesney, Bar at the End of the World. This is Tim and Adam, and we were just talking a minute ago about how recording artists in, you know, country music is what I know, but how they are actually recording the songs that you hear on the radio. And Garth just claimed that he recorded his latest song in his own studio at home and did it with a full band, live track recording, which is very rare. But I spoke to Ashley McBride yesterday on our Instagram Live.
Okay.
Which is very cool. It's still up on our Instagram page at GoCountry 105 if you want to check it out. She also did two songs, I might add.
That's nice.
The best performer ever. She sounds so good. Oh, baby.
I could imagine.
She really, the best voice. She just grabs a guitar. I'm like, oh, my God.
A natural.
But she did the same thing. She actually recorded the album in a more traditional way. Ashley always gives credit to her band, which is something I think is so cool. But they do their own... I can't even think now. They do their own...
their own thing?
Oh, no. This is terrible. Well, the band basically... sorry. They do their own composition. They compose their own parts.
Okay.
Wow. That was the ultimate brain lapse.
Obviously, the Tim Hurley band isn't doing this.
They are, in fact, which is why I should know. They compose their own parts, which is huge in music. And then they are part of the songwriting process, and they also record all their own parts, which is incredibly rare. Oh. You might have heard the term studio musicians. And those are people that are specifically talented at recording in a studio because their timing is perfect. They can play any part very quickly. Sometimes when studio musicians are recording a song, it might be the first time they've ever heard the song.
Oh, wow.
So you can go in and literally play them a voice memo of what basically the song sounds like. And then they have a chart in front of them. And just by reading the music, they know exactly what to play.
Wow.
Bass, drums, whatever else. They go in and they just knock it out.
That is talent.
It's talent, but it also has a very different sound. So you hear an Ashley McBride, an Eric Church, a Garth Brooks recording, a lot of people feel like it sounds more organic and a little bit looser and stuff like that. And that's because a lot of times they have their own band going in and they all record together. So the musicians are vibing off each other as opposed to looking at a sheet playing each part. Way more complicated. Requires way more talent because you are asking these guys not only to play their parts perfectly timed and in tune and all of that stuff, but they're playing it with other people in the room and with a singer, and it's one take, because if one person screws up one part,
you have to redo the whole thing.
So that's incredibly incredible amount of talent that it takes, and Ashley McBride's band is fantastic. They're called Dead Horse. She's been with them forever. I think she said she's with one of the guys since she was 16 years old.
Wow.
So listen to it.
That is amazing.
True talent. And they sound, because of that, sound just as good on stage as they do on their recordings.
And you know what?
What?
the more you know
with Tim. We're probably going to get fined for using that thing. Right now, we got another real natural talent. Luke Combs, Love It On You on Go Country 105.
I'm in love. Hollywood, Cypress, Inglewood. Thanks for listening to Go Country 105.
Every morning, turning it on
Go Country 105.